Hello everyone, this is Josh at TechPodge, and today I'm going to do a very quick video on Adobe Acrobat Pro. So if you're new to Pro, or if you want a simple quick refresher, this is the video for you. So here we are in the Adobe Acrobat Pro interface, and you can see the recent tab has already been selected in this quick links panel over here. So recent has been selected, as you can see, any files that I've starred, and also recent files I'm working on. In fact, if you click on one, if I click on a file, you can see you're going to get a thumbnail view over here, which is quite helpful with some quick actions that you can take on that file. So on this quick links file over here, you can see you can visit starred files, or I can also visit any files on my computer. So your files, and you can see I can organize these in the cloud with new folders anytime simply by clicking new folder. I've also got any files that are shared by myself or shared by others, and below that, agreements. So any agreements, for example, documents that I've sent for signature that are in progress or waiting for myself, any documents that have been signed by everyone and are completed, appear, or canceled. So if I go back to the home screen here, I'm going to go back to the home tab and look at my recent files. You can see here at the top here, there's also a list of all the tools within Adobe Acrobat Pro. So if I click on that, I can see all the tools available to me for editing a PDF, for example, editing, organizing, for converting it to a different file type altogether. If I want to convert a PDF to a PowerPoint, for example, or if I want to convert a PowerPoint or a Word document into a PDF, or if I want to compress it. You can also create your documents here. You can sign your documents here, send for signature, okay, create a web form. You can protect it here, redact a PDF, share and review, add comments, for example, send for comments, add a stamp, a watermark, for example, or prepare it, prepare for accessibility, for example, if you want to allow people to read it out loud, and so on. So if I go back here to the Home tab, and if I open up a document, for example, this one here, you're going to see that there's all these same tools are available to me under the All Tools tab. So now I've opened up this PDF, and remember, all of these tools will be available to you on the left-hand side. So you don't have to go to this page to use the tools. You can simply open up a document. And by the way, all your documents that you open will appear at the top here. You can see all of these tools will be available to you in this panel. You can also edit here. So if I click on Edit, I click on the Edit tab, I can now click in this text field, and you can see I have all the options for editing the text, changing the font type, for example, changing the size, color, and so on. I can select the image here, and it's going to give me the option to crop the image among other options. I can convert it here as well. So I can click on the Convert tab, and I can convert it to Word, PowerPoint, and so on. And I can send for signature here too. I can sign out, I can request a signature, or I can add my own signature simply by clicking Add Signature. And now I've got the option to draw my signature, type it, or even add an image. But I'll cancel out of that. And now, as you can see, if I go back up here, I also have the option to quickly create documents. So this tab will always be here. Okay, if I close this all together, if I close that and I close this tab, this create tab will always be here for us to quickly create a PDF. So you've got the option to create a PDF, to combine files, to open files. So if I click here, create PDF, you can see now that I've got the option to create a single file. If I want to convert a Word document, for example, into a PDF, I can quickly do it here, or I can create multiple files. So in other words, I can create one PDF from multiple files, create a single PDF from multiple files. I can do a screenshot here. Window capture, selection, capture. Bear in mind, you have to give Adobe permission to access your computer. Okay, so that might take a minute, but that's just a handy option. And you can also do a scanner. So you just need to select your scanner, and you can do a web page. You can actually type in a web page, www.nasa.gov, and it will actually generate a PDF of that web page, which is pretty cool. You also can, create a PDF from things on your clipboard, or simply start with a blank page. So if I can start with a blank page here and create, I've now got a blank page in Adobe to begin working with. So if I go back here to my recent files, I want to show you one more thing here. You can see here I've got the TechPodge documents I've been working on. I'm going to open that up again. And you can see up top here, you've got all your menu options. So for example, under Acrobat, if you want to check your spelling, change your spelling, go to here to preferences. And you can see here, you can actually change the language that you're working under spelling. Simply click spelling and you can change the language. Simply add here another version of English or French, for example, or German. Cancel out of that. Okay, you've got plenty of other options here. This is a massive menu, as you can see. Cancel that. And under file here, of course, you can open other files. And you can also see the document properties, which is important to know because that's where you're going to go to check the security and change the security, etc. So I hope you've enjoyed this quick review of Adobe Acrobat Pro. And if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe, as I'm going to produce many more videos just like this that are really short and simple to get you up to speed very quickly on Adobe apps. So thanks for joining, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.